Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to our first ever series of webcasts produced by our grade 12 students. Please allow me to address the students first. My dear grade 12 students, congratulations in advance. In class, we always talk about how the application of knowledge is the real power, and I'm looking forward to watching all of these webcasts because it will really show how you have taken advantage and are using all of your strengths and greatness to create a better impact in your community and hopefully in the world. To our speakers, the coordinators, and especially Sir Redem, for taking time to guide the students and sharing your knowledge and expertise in these relevant topics. We thank you for your time and we look forward to learning from you. And finally, to everyone who will be watching our webcast, like my students, I invite you to apply the knowledge that you will learn, because it is only through the application of knowledge that we can really reap the benefits of these. And at the same time, please feel free to share the knowledge or the webcast so that more people will be informed, will be helped, and protected. Congratulations again to everyone who is part of this webcast, and have a great day.
Hello, everybody. First and foremost, let me extend my praise to the grade 12 students under the helm of Mr. Redem Taco, their instructor in the subject Empowering Technology. Now, this webcast presentation, a combined word of web and broadcast, is indeed a milestone for the BIS online learning program. It is wonderful to note also that this webcast would tackle relevant issues and concerns that everyone should know. Truly excited to mention also that our students are aware on the 2022 elections. They may not be qualified yet to vote, but the interest to be informed as regards the relevance behind this election is a proof that they are part of the society. I'm also looking forward to seeing how this event would be able to juxtapose two related topics, cybersecurity and threats online. Being in the era of technology, every user or owner needs to be protected from cybercrime, hackers, spyware, computer viruses, and the parameter of the data protection policy. Now, adding thrill to this webcast is a former BIS teacher would be sharing a topic that is timely and relevant. This will surely help everyone on how to cope up on the online school and mental health amidst the pandemic. Exciting, isn't it? So once again, to the grade 12 students, with Mr. Taco, congratulations. And to the esteemed speakers, thank you for saying yes to share your expertise to everyone present in this webcast presentation. Thank you so much, and thank you, God.
Hello everyone, welcome to part 1 to your online security journey, known as Gen Part 1, where we learn about a generation's online security activity. Born through a party in the county jail. So don't stop me now.
Don't stop me. Somebody once told me.
My name is Sunny Lee.
And I am Gabriel Go, here to interview our student guest speaker, Justin. How are you, Justin? Would you like to tell everyone who are you and your achievements?
I'm Justin Arcaina, and when it comes to achievements, it's only a few but not much. I've recently finished my SDG project. I've improved in digital drawing, and I've read some investment books.
Shall we get into the interview? Okay, let's start. Did you know, according to a survey by the National Cybersecurity Alliance, 96% of Gen Z express their ability to keep their data online safe, although it does not result in being secured at all?
On a scale of 1 to 10, how safe do you think you are online? Why that number?
If I'm going to be honest, only 5. Because many big companies want your data, and so there are many hackers and doxers.
We are now doing everything online. Classes are online. Researching for answers are online. Meeting friends through online. Shopping and everything.
What do you personally do to be safe online?
I personally use some minimal stuff, such as using the Opera browser, since it has many built-in features that help me be safe. I may also invest using the Brave browser in the future, because thanks to it being Web3, it gives privacy back to the individual.
As a student and as part of the younger age group, how do you keep yourself safe and secured online?
As a student, it is important because we have many stuff like our accounts for schooling to use it. If it gets hacked, that will be a problem. So what we do is I do as a student is just research more on online safety. So I know what to do.
We know that technology is part of our lives, especially as the younger ones. Even when we are toddlers, we already had gadgets, right?
Correct.
We easily forget, or we think downly about security since we use it every day and nothing happens. How can we spread awareness about the importance of staying secure and safe online, especially to our fellow Gen Z?
No, the answer there is simple. We just need to educate others online. We should share articles that will help us become more safe online, because now we have the tools to spread awareness and we have the tools to research these things.
And this is for now the Gen Part 1. Thank you to Justin for letting us know what gist on what the younger generation thinks about online security and safety.
Stay tuned for Section 2, where our other members talk with a teacher and their knowledge to this topic right after this break. See you. Bye.
Preview.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna...
Hi everyone, my name is Jovido De Vise, and here with us today is Miss Michelle C. Aloha. She is one of the respected teachers in our school, Benedictine International School. She has been teaching in Benedictine International School for quite some time. Good morning, Miss Michelle. How are you?
Good morning. I'm doing good. Thank you for asking.
Would you like to introduce yourself to everyone?
Oh, yes. Oh, I like the picture. All right. So, I'm Miss Aloha. I am currently the online coordinator in Benedictine. I graduated in Liloheyo Amang Rodriguez Institute of Science and Technology with a major of Bachelor of Science in Industrial Education. I am an NCQ certified and a TESOL certified teacher.
Miss, did you know that Millennials and Generation X are one of the more not secure people in the online world? This is due to not being exposed to technology at an early age.
So yes, I believe that online nowadays is not so secured for millennials, especially that they are exploring more about being exposed to technology.
With this information, on a scale of 1 to 10, how safe do you think you are on the internet?
Oh, I can say that maybe 8, because I believe that I know how to do privacy setting and strong password for online emails and accounts. And I do not upload things that I don't want others to see. But I give the 2 for others, like I still know that there are other people who are more tech-savvy than I. So they can use these skills to their advantage, for their own purpose, maximizing the technology.
That's something to think about. How yes. Did the pandemic change your perspective of online security?
Oh yeah, well, the pandemic forced everyone, especially employees, to work from home. This, therefore, the technology become even more important to our work and personal life. So, in my thinking, everyone uses internet as means of their daily activities. So I just feel like I should be more cautious about online security. So now I always make sure that I change my password more often than before. Before I don't do this very often, but now I make it a habit to change password for my online account. Yes, Jovi.
I know teachers are one of the most affected people this time of pandemic. You need to adapt with the sudden changes and teach and do everything online. Most of our teachers always say that they are not techie and had a hard time adapting to these changes. How did this online journey make you realize how unsafe you are online?
Thank you. Nothing much about online class, but maybe when I heard that there are a lot of online hackers, so hackers can easily get information from social media accounts and they can duplicate this information to their own advantage, right? So I just like to use online, like me, I just like to use online payment, shopping, mobile banking, and this has been so famous for quite some time now, right? So that is why the internet is a good source for hackers to get information, even the most confidential information that they need to know. Okay, so that is why now I realize that privacy setting for all of my online accounts is really important.
Okay, that's good to know. Why is online safety important to your profession?
Oh yeah, thank you for asking that, because that's one of the challenges that teachers faced last year, right? So as teacher, we should make our online classes effective and interactive, right? So the advantage of having online classes is that there are a lot of educational services and resources out there in the internet, right? To make our studying or teaching fun and interactive. But not all of them are trustworthy, right? Okay, so it is very important for us teachers to research educational resources before we recommend them to the student or before using them in our classes. We have to make sure that there are other people who have had positive experience from security, online safety, and privacy perspective.
Indeed, online safety is important in all professions. What do you personally do to make yourself safe online?
Oh yeah, so aside from privacy setting that I've been mentioning and making strong password for online emails and account, I do not upload things that I don't want others to see. So maybe my selfies, that's fine. So no, just kidding. So there. So those important information that I don't want others to see and I don't want, I think that they are too personal to share, I don't upload them online. All right. So also I do background check for any important transactions that I need to deal online.
Great. Maybe others can do it as well to be safe online. Being part of the older generation at a teacher, how can we promote online security, especially to people who are not techie?
With my basic understanding of online safety, well, I know the basics, right? So with this little understanding of mine, I can help to keep the students safe by at least talking to them about their internet use, what do they search on internet, how often do they use internet, and then basically teaching them about online dangers, right? Informing them how to be safe online. And then I can also use my learning or searching other things in internet and basically informing the student this online safety that can make them inform, they can let, I can let them make informed decision when it comes to internet safety.
All right. Thank you for joining us today in Know Your Gen Part 2. We appreciate your time and effort. If you want to know about the big questions more, stay tuned for the next section where my group leads will interview a professional in the field. We'll be right back.
The sky's falling, the wind is calling, stand for something or die in the morning. Section 80, high power.
Hello everyone, welcome back. My name is
Kim, and welcome to The Last Draw,
where we ask professionals small to big time questions that the people would like to know.
This is Mr. Aldrin P. Obsanga, a professional in the field of technology security. Can you talk about yourself a little, sir?
Hello, I'm Sir Aldrin Obsanga. So I'm currently an instructor in PUP Paranaque campus. I graduated magna cum laude year 2019 at this university also. And I started teaching also after I graduated. So I teach programming subjects, networking subjects. And I also have trainings with Cisco Certified Network Association.
Thank you for being with us today, sir. We know that we are experiencing hard times right now, and we are grateful to have you. Okay, so in a world where practically technology is surrounding us, it is inevitable for us to stumble upon inconveniences and a lot of threats. Basically, the internet is a big ocean with hungry sharks around us trying to get our information and data.
Mm-hmm. So here's the question. Are there any rules about internet safety that everyone should know? Or something like tips?
So you already have your netiquette rules when you are doing your online class, right? So let's put the cybersecurity side of the rules. First, keep your software or applications up to date, because the cyber criminals and the developers are like a cat and mouse, no? Paunahan sila kung magkaroon ng issue si developer, cyber criminal aatake yan before pa magkaroon ng patch si developer. Next is, be careful when dealing with emails from unknown sources. And don't click unknown link or online advertisement. And free software is not always safe. Kasi madalas pagka hindi natin kayang bumili ng software pero kailangan talaga natin gamitin. So, ang last resort natin is to use free software, but it is not always safe. If you are not sure about the software that you want to use, you may try to Google it and see the details. And do not reveal sensitive information online, obviously. Social media is the first place that criminals are checking to gather information if you are their victim. So do not post everything or sensitive information in your social media accounts. Keep your account information to yourself, and I do not recommend to use similar password to different websites. Also, you have to report illegal activities or if offending content. And keep in mind that what you post online stays there forever unless there is a human intervention to delete it. You may also use anti-malware protection before you go online. And create backup copies for your important stuff so that if your data is stolen, you have a backup copy for yourself.
Okay, so another question. So what are some easy tips to start our online security journey? Since like people usually forget the fundamentals and even the basic ones.
So pwede kayo mag-start to check your privacy settings on your social media accounts. Check what are the data that the others or the public can see. Explore the privacy settings of your social media accounts. If you want to pursue cybersecurity naman, you may check the basics or understand the networking first, how the network works. Then check what are the softwares available to be more secure when you exploring online or browsing online.
So next will be, how can we make the user authentication process more secure? Like, are passwords enough or is double authentication essential?
Yes, you have mentioned it, the double authentication. Yun, that is the first advice. You may use the multi-factor authentication functionality. So, example, yung sa one-time PIN, especially if you are dealing with bank transfers, you use multi-factor authentication. And do not reuse your passwords. And use single sign-on functionality or SSO. Yung single sign-on functionality, yung for example, yung sa Google, isang sign-in ka na lang, then pwede ka nang naka-sign-in ka na sa YouTube, sa Google Drive, lahat ng soft application ng Google. So, i-combine mo yung multi-factor authentication and single sign-on functionality. Use a password manager. If necessary, kasi hindi ka nga pa ulit-ulit ng password, pwedeng makalimutan mo. So, that is when the password manager comes in handy. And generate strong and unique passwords. Combination of uppercase, lowercase, numbers, symbols. There is a reported data breach in a particular website and you have account on that website. Change your password immediately and do not use easier to answer security questions when you forget your password. Use answers that only you should can think of, and make use of VPNs. It's advisable, yung virtual private networks, and be aware of your surroundings when you are surfing online or browsing your social media. Be aware of who are the people you are with. Maybe behind you, they are trying to snoop your password when you are in a public vehicle. No? And do not leave your device unattended in public places. And you may also explore those advices for the password authentication. You may also explore the passwordless authentication that includes biometrics and biometrics, fingerprint, scanning, face recognition.
So as what we said earlier, the internet is basically a big ocean filled with hungry sharks, especially that we're doing everything online now. Everything we usually do face-to-face, we can do it through online, such as banking, grocery shopping, and online shopping. Yes. We're putting our personal information out there, and sometimes we are reckless, too reckless. So it's basically a buffet for hackers and scammers now.
So our question is, what are the common types of cyber attacks and how can we prevent them from happening to us?
Okay, first of all, you are all familiar with this malware. So included here are the ransomware, spyware, virus, worms, Trojan horses. So that's all part of malicious software or malware. For prevention, I think everyone has the best way to prevent this kind of attacks, and that is common sense. If you have your common sense, you know when what are the websites you have to visit, what are the buttons you have to click online through your common sense. Of course, that is in addition with the firewalls, with the encryptions, and user authentication.
What are some vulnerabilities in network security, and can you explain it a little?
Ah, okay. Vulnerabilities. Actually, related yun sa previous question nyo, no? So, vulnerabilities natin yun sa malware yun. Okay? Sa malware. Kasi madaling mapakalat ng malware. You can just makapag-click ka lang ng isang attachment sa email. So, vulnerability na yung emails natin. Yun sa social engineering attacks, wherein they copy some kind of a form on a website and they will be able to get your information. It seems like really a legitimate website, but it is not. And they just want to get your credit card information or sensitive information about you if you are the target. And then also updated or unpatched software that is a potential vulnerability. You have outdated software because yung updates, kaya nga pagka nag-i-install tayo ng updates, merong mga patch. That is for the security issues. Okay? May mga ports sila kasi na pwedeng open doon sa previous software. Nagkakaroon tayo ng pagpapatch doon. Another vulnerability is misconfigured firewalls or operating system. Kasi pagka nag-create tayo ng network natin sa organization, we are configuring the firewall. Huwag natin siyang i-left behind na naka-default yung policies niya. So we have to configure it.
Okay, so since we're in the topic of vulnerability and hackers, one question I always think about is, I'm sure a lot of people too, but why do hackers hack and what do they gain from it?
What do they gain from it? Of course, your information is very important. Kasi we are in the world of data. Everything is in the digital platform. Lahat ng activities mo online, actually, na-detect ng iyong ISP, Internet Service Provider, and ng websites kung saan ka nakasubscribe. So, lahat ng information na ilagay mo doon. Very important yun sa mga hacker kasi kung alam nila kung saan ka nagpupunta, ano yung location mo, paano yung browsing history mo, saan ka interested na mga bagay, pwede sila magkaroon ng identity theft, gagayahin nila or gagamitin nila yung photos mo sa social media na kunyari ikaw yun, then manghihingi sila ng mga pera. That's what they gain, the data.
What should we do if we feel like we are being hacked or we notice something that's unusual?
When you get hacked, so may idea ka na, alam mo na na-hack yung social media account mo. Take stock of the situation. Take screenshots, take note of what you can witness, ano yung proof mo na na-hack ka. Then use it to report it to the professionals, the cybercrime division pa rin. You cannot do it all by yourself. If you want to get the culprit or ikaw mismo yung huhuli doon sa hacker, you cannot do it all by yourself because internet is very broad, no? Malaking mundo na ito eh. Make sure to change your password immediately. Inform your friends and online connections. Report any spam or spam posts on your profile. They might already create a post there with the link na pag kinlik mo, ayun na, may fill out ka na form or magda-download yung specific program. And delete all the sensitive data on the affected account. And you have to remove the other online accounts that are linked to that account. And scan the device using the anti-malware software. And also, you may contact the help centers. If it is a Facebook account, you may report it to the Facebook help center.
So this past year has been a learning journey for everyone. I'm sure in terms of online security and technology, each day we are getting more and more advanced in terms of technology. And because we are advancing, there are some threats and problems popping and growing. So we want to know, what are some things or actions you think that we all should leave behind and forget doing in the new normal or in the tech world?
Sige, sabihin na lang natin na ito na lang yung paglaanan nyo sa new normal. Not yung stay connected with friends, okay? And manage your mental health. Ito yung mga magaganda ninyong gawin sa new normal. Get reflections of yourself. Then you have to know how to deal with cyberbullying. Don't fall for fake news. Ang daming fake news online. Hindi mo na alam kung alin yung totoo. Tsaka pag nagkaroon ng isang pangyayari, ang bilis kumalat sa online. So, check nyo kung ano talaga yung nangyari. Okay? So, hindi yung comment tayo ng comment agad. Then, you may also balance your time online. Okay, kung sa tingin nyo toxic na, puro problema na yung nakikita nyo online, so, pwede kayong magpahinga. Pwedeng turn off nyo muna yung cellphone nyo. Focus on other things. Ah, ito pala, so uso din to. So, yung online relationship, you have to be cautious about online relationship, especially in this new normal. I don't think this is the right time to find you're the one. So, because it is also a time for them to attack na magpapanggap sila that they are liking you. And then, ipe-pressure ka na nila. Something like that, or your information. Okay, so you have to be cautious about online relationships.
So one thing I've heard about, like, before the pandemic is using public Wi-Fi. So, as what you said, sir, public Wi-Fi are very risky. So, can you talk more about it po?
Public Wi-Fi. So, ito marami na ito. Because this is a project of PICT and the free Wi-Fi, People Connect. Public Wi-Fi, when you say public Wi-Fi, it is unencrypted. Okay? Hindi siya kagaya nung ating nakasubscribe tayo sa ISP. Pag public Wi-Fi, ibig sabihin unencryption, lahat ng ginagawa mo doon, when you connected to the public Wi-Fi, nakikita yon ng mga nakakonect doon din sa public Wi-Fi. Okay, halimbawa, yung hacker nakakonect din doon sa public Wi-Fi, ikaw nakakonect din doon sa public Wi-Fi. So, yung mga internet activity mo, kung ano yung mga binabrowse mo online, nakikita nila yan. And then, nakikita din nila yung tinatype mo, yung username mo, yung password mo, kung ginamit mo yung banking, nakikita rin nila yan. And that is where the virtual private network or VPN comes in.
So, I reversed the question po. What are some things we should be doing more in terms of online security and safety in the new norm?
Ayun, parang nabanggit ko na siya dun sa question mo kanina na yung what you have to forget or stop doing. Focus on yourself more in this new normal. Then, try to learn something, how you will be safe and secure. Okay? Check nyo nga yung sa privacy settings, what are the legitimate websites. And you may also explore networking side, the protocols, no? Yung na ginagamit ng mga websites, kasi may mga protocols yan. And you might also want to use websites only that are secure. Isang palatandaan dyan yung ginagamit na protocol, dun sa lock, makikita niyo pagka nag-i-access kayo ng link, there is a lock there that means that website has the SSL certificate or the secure sockets layer certificate. And makikita niyo naka HTTPS siya. Ibig sabihin, HTTP is secure. So yun, that is just some of the knowledge that you can gain also from the internet.
So basically, I have read from online articles that people actually use VPNs a lot. And for me, I have VPN in my cell phone and also in my laptop. Do they actually help? They really help? And are they really beneficial for us?
Hey, yes, absolutely. What the VPN does is that it routes all your data through another server to help you increase online security and privacy. When you connect to the internet without a VPN, you are gaining access directly through your internet service provider's network access point. Kung ano mang ISP yan, Globe or PLDT or Converge, okay? They are going to give you, they will give you a modem. Then that modem acts as your firewall and router. So it is an all-in-one device. And together with that, they will give you an IP address. Okay, so yung isang IP address na binigay sa inyo ng ISP nyo, yun yung way para makakonnect kayo dun sa internet. Then, lahat ng kukonnect dun sa Wi-Fi na nakasubscribe kayo, bibigyan din nila ng different IP address from the IP address that they've given on your modem. So that is without a VPN. When you have the VPN, I forgot to mention, because it is through your ISP directly. So kung directly siya, everything that you do online, all of your internet activity can be seen by your ISP. Okay? So everything you type on your cell phone online, they can be seen by your ISP. With VPN naman, you're routing your computer's connection or your device's connection through a server located somewhere else first. So before you can access the internet, kukunik ka muna dun sa virtual server. So kung mapapansin nyo, pag nag-connect tayo sa VPN, nag-iiba yung ating location, no? So, yun yung ginagamit natin na IP address. Sila yung nag-a-assign ng IP address. Imbis na mag-a-assign sa atin ay yung sa ISP natin, yung virtual private network. So, the advantages is that you appears anonymous to the internet. And then, you can bypass geo-blocks. Kasi you're anonymous nga. So you may bypass geo-blocks. Yung geo-blocks, ito yung mga restrictions for every country. Diba, sa country na to, hindi pwede yung ganitong website. So they can bypass it. They can also bypass firewalls. Then it have additional encryptions to protect your data from hackers.
Okay, so as what we said earlier, technology is surrounding us and it's basically part of our daily life. Being literate, knowing how to read and write is not enough to survive in this world. We need to be information literate, financially literate, and more. So we would like to know how important is technology literacy and being aware of what's happening online and how can this help us be more protected online.
People nowadays are looking to the internet as the key source of information. So if they want to know something, they just browse the internet. Those people who are digitally literate or technology literate, they know how to find and consume digital content. Not only to find and consume, but they are also able to evaluate what are the right information. They know how to evaluate what are the legitimate websites. they know what to click and what not to click online. And they are able to communicate online and share online content so that they cannot be a victim.
Nowadays, I have seen many issues surrounding many social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and technology brands where they use our data and sell them. Technology and the internet is such a powerful thing. We can do a lot of things that make the world a better place, and we can also use it to destroy and create chaos. Then how can we empower technology and convince everyone to use it in a good side? And how can we, and how can being secured online start that?
I think the technology empowers us as humans develop them. Sabi mo nga, ang daming benefits ng internet, okay? Gives us the ability to put the power of learning to the hands of the learners. When you want knowledge, when you want to build or improve your skills, that is all available online. Technology is part of the change, and there will always be a change. So, as time goes by, there will be changes in technology, more modernization, and you don't want to be left behind. But as you go simultaneously with the technology, you have to be aware, or you have to know how you will be safe and secure in the digital platform. In that way, when all people knows, let's say that all people knows how they can be safe and secure online, I think people will use the technology for good, because people already knows how to deal with hackers or scammers, and they cannot become a victim of phishing or cyber or other cyber attacks.
So basically, you think that the advantages of technology like outweigh the disadvantages, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's all our questions, sir. Thank you for being with us. But before we end this session, are there anything you would like to say to our viewers and the world?
Find your purpose in life, then work on that purpose. If you already found your purpose, learn about that purpose. Knowledge is already at your fingertips. Continue to learn what you want to learn or what you need to learn. But keep in mind that more knowledge comes with more responsibility. You are responsible for whatever you will do and you will share in public. You are responsible for your safety and security in the digital.
Okay, so we would like to thank you again, Sir Aldrin, again with helping us with this recording, being with us despite your busy schedule.
Okay, so thank you everyone. We are the Online Security and Safety Group, and we are signing off. Thank you for watching.
Always remember that staying safe online is important as staying safe offline. Thank you.